Hey there once again, YouTube. First off, if you haven't already, please check out my website. A link is provided below, under my email address, actually. It can help you find, access, and analyze seismic and GPS deformation data. It can teach you how to understand the many different types of seismic plots and charts people use. And it also contains a great many seismic plots and images relating to a great many different earthquake swarms and events. Now, so this is just a chat about a certain YouTube live stream that hasn't been around for a little while. And guys, I am talking about SpectroNet. Yes, I had a terrible run-in with SpectroNet about a year ago or so, right when I was first starting this channel, long before I had my website. Now, I haven't seen SpectroNet live much at all lately, so I decided to search his channel on YouTube and see what's up. Come to find out, there were a great many people who were either scammed by SpectroNet, completely attacked by him for no reason, or other things that occurred. I soon came to find out that it was not just me that had a problem, but many other people too. The purpose of this video is to add another testimony to the list of others that have had bad experiences with SpectroNet, and to warn you to just be wary if you talk to him. If you look in the links section in the description box below, you will find links to some other people's videos about SpectroNet. Now you could do that, or simply just search SpectroNet in the YouTube search bar and see what comes up. If you're new to seismic monitoring or YouTube, please be wary of SpectroNet. According to other people, he has scammed others out of their money and actually almost, he didn't, but almost scammed me out of money, while claiming that the seismic data and the program swarm was his. There were also some other experiences that can only be told by those who went through it. Now, that didn't really shock me at all that there are other people that had problems, but I'm glad that there are other people getting their testimony out there just so people do not get scammed. Before I get into seismic data and the program swarm, and how Scott of SpectroNet does not own any of it, here's my experience with him. Now, this all happened when I was first starting my YouTube channel. I believe I only had 2 videos that I ever made. Now, don't get me wrong, my videos used to be horrid. I was wrong quite literally all the time. I have grown much since then, but I'm getting off track. One day I discovered SpectroNet. It was pretty much the first real source of seismic data I ever monitored. I loved SpectroNet at first, and I thought it was pretty cool and looked pretty cool. At first, like many others, I didn't have any problems with the mods or with Scott at all. However, one day there was an earthquake or an earthquake swarm. I don't exactly remember what it was, but I opened my screen capture tool that I used to record my videos and recorded a very small portion of a certain spectrogram that showed the activity of interest. Then I put it in my next video, gave SpectroNet big credit for it since the source was the SpectroNet live stream, and I uploaded the video. See, although I didn't know how seismic data accessibility worked, I assumed that I could do that and give him credit. Now, whether I was right or wrong is not the point. Next day, I went back and thanked Scott for what he did and notified him that I put it in my video and I gave him the credit. Then, all of a sudden, Scott and his mods attacked me like crazy, saying that they would shut my channel down, give me copyright strikes in all my videos, etc. Now, this puzzled me greatly, and we did have an argument over chat. Overall, near the end of the argument, I asked him, "So, why are you guys so mad that I did this if I notified you and gave you big credit? My channel doesn't receive any money or donations or anything, so it is strictly a non-profit educational channel." That is quite literally what I said near the end of the argument. Want to know what Scott from SpectroNet said? And I quote, "Next time you need to ask permission before stealing someone else's work. Next time if you want seismic data, you will need to pay me. After all, scientists rarely freely share data." Huh? So guys, now that I look back on that day, I'm so glad I did not give him any money for any seismic data. If I would have, I would have been falling for a scam. And I'm not the only one that has gone through this. So my video was taken down, and I contacted YouTube and pleaded my case. I don't think my video ever went back up, but after months and months of just waiting, the one copyright strike against my channel, which was put there because of SpectroNet, has since been removed. Thank God. Now I want to warn everyone that Scott's SpectroNet channel was cool, yes, but the only thing that was his was the text and the clock. The spectrograms, the program used to generate them, and the actual seismic data being shown by the spectrograms were not his whatsoever, and you cannot claim a copyright strike against something that's not yours. Period. And for him to claim otherwise in order to get money, I believe is fraud. Well, at least I think it is. If you have ever had a bad run-in with SpectroNet, please let me know below. Now, the stream that you see here is all mine. Just kidding, guys. This stream is not on the internet, but is being streamed live, directly from the seismic stations themselves, via the seismic program Swarm. None of this data is mine, and neither is the program. The following can easily be proven by visiting the many links on my website. My website can teach you where to find seismic data and with what programs to analyze it with, including Swarm, and shows the fact that all of this is completely 100% free. 101% free. Yes, if you ever hear anyone tell you that you have to pay for seismic data, that is always a scam. 100% for sure. Kind of like how you know 100% for sure that any IRS phone calls to get money from you are scams. I mean, I doubt anyone falls for those anymore. Well, at least I hope not. So nobody should fall for SpectroNet scams either. Seriously though, if I had to pay for my seismic data for all my research that I conduct, do you know how much money I probably would have spent by now? Likely tens to possibly hundreds of thousands of dollars, guys. I mean, I go through an insane amount of seismic data within just a week. Maybe like over a terabyte. I'm not joking because I download a lot. Some of the seismic data I don't use, like if I gather from the wrong station, then I delete it or whatever. But seriously, if I had to pay for it, guys, I would have broke the bank a long time ago. So here we are at google.com. In the search bar, let's search USGS Swarm. Click enter. And as other people have said, this volcanoes.usgs.gov. Nobody can have that but the government, just like the other person said in one of the other videos talking about SpectroNet. So let's click this, and here we are. This is the, well, once it comes up, there we go. This is the download page for the seismic program Swarm. A link is provided below. All you do is click this, which will download and put into your download folder, open the .zip file, and double-click Swarm underline console. Swarm will open along with its black window and you are good to go. Swarm was created by the Alaska Volcano Observatory in conjunction with USGS and IRIS. Swarm is completely 100% free and in the public domain. If you are ever asked to pay for this program by anyone, do not. It's a scam. Swarm can generate helicorders and even seismograms, spectrogram, or spectra plots, either in real time on the Swarm program itself, as you saw just a bit ago, or from past data obtained through IRIS. Scott from SpectroNet is not a geologist or a seismologist and has never been associated with IRIS or USGS. And even if he has, he still has no right to make people pay for Swarm or seismic data. Not even the professionals have that right. So I don't understand why Scott would say something like that to anyone, because actually, on his website, which doesn't have that great of information, but it does have some stuff on there, he does state that USGS made Swarm. So I'm a little confused. Well, you know, maybe that was added just recently because he got in trouble. I don't know. But I'm comforted in knowing that it was not just me that had the problem. And this is the program Swarm. You see I have the earthquake monitor up, and I have multiple spectrograms from MCID and YMC-YML. This is from Yellowstone right here. These two are from Utah near the Black Rock Volcanic Field. Seeing some interesting low-frequency events lately. I'm not going to get into the analysis right now because I'm not analyzing these things right now. And these two are from Mount Rainier. Notice that you can add as many as you want for as long as you want. You could change anything. And this is what SpectroNet had, guys, for his stream. Let's go to Help. Let's click About. Looks like it says SWARM stands for Seismic Wave Analysis and Real-Time Monitoring, developed by the United States Geological Survey with contributions from ISTI and IRIS. Very interesting. Free memory, total memory. Okay, so did not say Scott from SpectroNet on there. Isn't that interesting? And plus, you can also go to the Alaska Volcano Observatory website, and they do have links on there about how they developed SWARM. And on, excuse me, on GitHub, they actually have a page on there. If you don't know what GitHub is, it's for, I believe it's for developers, like program developers. They have a page on there for Swarm from the developers, so you can say, hey, are there any glitches, any mistakes? Hey, I'm going to report a mistake, I'm going to report a glitch, and they usually get around to fixing it sometimes. But yeah, guys, it's not SpectroNet's. It's everybody's. Now, this is one of the many data retrieval websites. Others include the IRIS Time Series URL Builder, the NCEDC Data Select, SCEDC Data Select, and many more. Remember, all seismic data is free and in the public domain and can be accessed anytime. A link to this is also provided below and especially on my website where I teach you how to do some of this stuff. The Iris Data Select URL Builder you see here is the number one data retrieval source that I use for all my research and all my plots. If you guys follow me, then you know that I use this many, many times a day. I am well versed in finding seismic data, even for some locations in the world where it's hard to find seismic data. And never, not once, throughout all my research and all the hundreds, if not thousands of plots that I have made, have I paid one penny. Nada. Nothing. 100% for free. Remember, the many pages on my website, especially under the How To drop-down menu, can basically teach you how to do everything that you see me do in my blog posts and on my videos. Now, I haven't seen SpectroNet go live on YouTube for quite some time. Maybe he got enough money from people, got in trouble, or is just moving on to something else. Regardless, there are actually many different types of earthquake monitors on YouTube that do, stream spectrograms, especially some that stream spectrograms from Swarm. So, let's go to the search bar right up here. Let's type in earthquake. Press enter. Let it load. Now press filter. And go to live right here. Okay, so notice how there are many different earthquake monitor streams, such as Matthew Shipley, Kiwi Quakes. Let's see, where is Matthew Shipley? Is he on right now? Matthew Shipley, where is he? Yep, there he is right there. See, Swarm, USGS Iris Swarm Data. Who else is online? We got Dynamic Earth Community. They monitor Yellowstone. They also got spectrograms there. And we also have Kiwi Quakes International Spectros, which is one of the ones that I do support and I do watch from time to time. And again, there are many, many channels that I do support and I am subscribed to as Matthew Shipley, Kiwi Quakes, and actually a channel named Sporky. Although these online streams are important, yes, I do believe it is best to analyze or stream seismic data on your own via the program Swarm if you wish to have a more immersive experience, so to speak. That way, if you want to manipulate or change the options any way you want, you can in the program Swarm. Something you obviously cannot do with the YouTube live stream. Again, if you ever hear anyone tell you that you should pay for any of these tools or data sources, do not fall for that scam. It is a scam, no matter what. Also, if you lie to get somebody's money, that's a scam, guys. That's fraud. Also, if you hear any other YouTuber adamantly telling you to basically only trust them, then obviously they really shouldn't be trusted, no matter how high your loyalty is to that YouTuber. Anyone with common sense or a good heart will be open to opposing opinions and other people's work. After all, we should try to learn from each other, guys, not separate each other. If any of you has ever had an experience like this, or like the other experiences posted on YouTube, please comment below. I would like to hear your run-ins with SpectroNet or other earthquake monitoring channels that have been extremely rude to you or have lied to you or tried to scam you. The purpose of this video was to add to the list of other testimonies about Scott from SpectroNet. Again, if you wish to see some of them, either go to the link section below or simply search SpectroNet in the YouTube search bar. Don't forget to check out my website and my recent videos, guys, and I will be back soon. Oh, hello, looky, looky. We do have, right here, an earthquake coming in on the RCS and RER feeds from, what is that? Yeah, Mount Rainier. Interesting, guys. Very interesting. Some lower frequencies there. That's very interesting. I'll have to take a look at that later. Don't know if it's an actual earthquake or an avalanche, because sometimes avalanches do happen, but it might be an earthquake. I'll check it out in a bit. See you later, guys. Have a great day. Also, real quick, guys, I forgot to add something to my video. This is not my video I'm showing right here. This is a clip from Kiwi Quakes International Spectros, one of the videos that he did. This notice was posted on SpectroNet's website. It is no longer there. I just looked through all of the pages. Maybe I missed it, but I don't think I missed it because it was put up in 5/28/2018. And I remember seeing this notice a while back, but I just went there and I don't see it on the website anymore. Maybe it was taken down because it's a big lie. Look at this. Check this out. And remember, this is not my video. Big shout out to Kiwi Quakes International Spectros. Please go subscribe to a channel if you want. Again, a link to this video will be provided in the description box below. You should watch it. It's kind of funny what SpectroNet says. At current, we are submitting takedown complaints for anyone attempting to use these particular spectrographs. Wait a second. Did he just say spectrograph? That's not the right term, bud. It's spectrograms. On YouTube, either in whole or in part because we believe that. And then he has a whole list. The professional level spectrographs are incorporated as part of a new, unique, first of its kind invention. What? Wait, so did he invent the spectrograms themselves? No, we already know that. Okay. Did he invent the seismic program Swarm, which creates the spectrograms? No, we already proved that. Okay. Did he invent the YouTube live stream? His own live stream, maybe, but he didn't invent actually YouTube. Basically, the only thing he invented was the text and the clock of his YouTube live stream. This invention, which is not really an invention because it's already been invented beforehand, provides a specific function, which is to seismically monitor the Ring of Fire world on one screen, as well as educate the user at the same time or participating in the overall system. That doesn't make any sense because you can stream all of that data through Swarm instead of his SpectroNet stream, and it's not his. Number three, the methodology for achieving this was partly developed by me. What? What? That is so not true. And the wide scope of its coverage is something that has never been done before on YouTube, not even by the USGS itself. What? Dude, there are so many. He acts like he's the first one to stream spectrograms on YouTube. That is so not true. Now, number four, the invention is part of an ongoing wider system of education for proper spectrogram interpretation. Dude, he doesn't even know how to read spectrograms or change the settings whatsoever, and even if he did, it's not an invention. He didn't invent it. A wider system of education, even though when people ask questions about the program or about anything volcanic at any volcanoes, he just shut them down immediately. Number five, attempted use of these professional level spectrographs for other purposes outside of the system is potentially harmful? What? Wait, so he's saying that it is harmful if anybody else but him does this spectrogram analysis. Wait, why should we trust him when he doesn't even know what a spectrogram obviously is? Because it's not a spectrograph, it's a spectrogram. Now, number six, attempted use of these spectrographs for other purposes outside of the system on YouTube constitutes infringement of the invention and bypasses the training system we provide to properly interpret them? What? Are you kidding me? He did not invent spectrograms. Do you know they even had seismic spectrograms like back in the 80s where they looked at the seismic waveform frequencies? Guys, wow. I'm just, wow. Okay, number seven. Regardless of where the copyright lies for any individual component of the system, at the very least, attempted use of these spectrographs or any other purpose on YouTube constitutes a violation of infringement of either our artwork, layout, design, monitoring purpose, or system purpose. Okay, now I admit the text and the clock is his and the live stream is his, but how can you file a copyright claim when the majority of what is on his live stream is seismic data that is free through the program Swarm? You cannot put copyright on something that isn't yours. And not only that, you can't put copyright on something that is free and in the public domain. Yeah, okay. The system is privately held and incorporated as part of an identifiable brand entity known as SpectroNet.org. The system, notice how he says the system, not just the live stream, but the system, meaning the spectrograms too. Right here, he stated the spectrograms and the data in the spectrograms are his. That is not true. That's a lie. You know, and I bet USGS and IRIS, I bet they would not be happy if they saw this. And maybe they did. And maybe that's not why he's really streaming much on YouTube anymore. Or maybe that's why he took this notice down. At least I think he took the notice down. I don't know for sure because I went back to his website and I couldn't find this notice. I remember seeing it back months ago when I had the problem with SpectroNet, but I don't know where it is on his website anymore. Considerable time, effort, and expense have been incurred as a result of producing this system. I could do it for one penny. Not even one penny. You could put it all on the seismic program Swarm. Yeah, maybe it takes some extra power in the computers to constantly stream all those. But the thing is it's still not his. You still cannot submit a copyright claim against someone who is quote-unquote stealing his work when it's not his work. And therefore, infringement or violation of it on YouTube does not constitute actionable damage, not only to me, but to SpectroNet.org and the people who work very hard as volunteers to help maintain it. Based on these key points above, we feel it is in our right and organizational interest to submit takedown complaints to YouTube. which he was doing to other places who actually have been streaming spectrograms longer than he has. YouTube has so far complied with all takedown requests and has removed all content that seeks to copy it or infringe upon it, either in whole or in part. He did that to scare people because that's a lie. If that was true, I would still have a copyright strike against my channel, and I don't. And I know there are some other people who got a copyright strike against them and they no longer have one. Because they found out, YouTube found out, probably, maybe even contacted by USGS and IRIS, that he was making money off something that was supposed to be free and in the public domain. Technically, that's illegal. I believe that's illegal. Therefore, at this time, it would not be advisable to anyone to attempt to broadcast these spectrographs in any form on YouTube. Wait, so he's saying that I can't go to the seismic program Swarm and stream the spectrograms from there on a YouTube live stream? Just because he's doing it, even though he did not create Swarm, he had no part in placing the seismic instruments where they are, he has no part in the data accessibility at all. What? That doesn't even make any sense. Because given that YouTube has complied 100% with some 15 to 20 notices already, if you attempt this at any time, your attempt will nearly certainly be removed. Wow. You know, he's got a big problem, guys. Now, I just wanted to add that on there. And I hope you guys have a great day. I'm out of here. See you later.